is God's special word. I love to read the Bible, and this is what I've heard. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. When I read the Bible, it tells me how to live. When I read the Bible, it tells me He forgives. 'Cause yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. When I read the Bible, it shows me how to love. And when I read the Bible, it makes me think of how, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. The Bible tells me so.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan.
And I'm Jessie.
Jessie, how was church this morning? Did you get to see your friends in your class?
Oh, I didn't go to my church today. Our family went to another church to see my aunt and uncle hold up my baby cousin in front of everybody.
Oh, you went to a dedication?
I don't know. The preacher said a bunch of stuff, and then the parents said some stuff, and then all the people said some stuff, and then everybody clapped.
You know what, Jessie? I think you went to your baby cousin's dedication. A dedication is when parents say they are going to help their child learn to follow God as he or she grows up, and the rest of the church family promises to help them.
Oh, so that's what they were talking about.
Yep. Today's Bible story is actually about when Jesus was dedicated.
Did Mary and Joseph hold up baby Jesus in front of everyone and then they clapped?
No, Mary and Joseph followed the Old Testament laws for dedicating Jesus. It looked much different than what we do today, but there were two people who were very happy to see baby Jesus. Listen to this story. Jesus came to earth as a baby. He was born in Bethlehem. Jesus' parents on earth were Mary and Joseph. They took care of Jesus. One day, when Jesus was still a baby, Mary and Joseph took Jesus to the temple. The temple was the place where people went to pray and worship God. Many years before, God had given special rules to all the people of Israel. One rule was, when a woman's first son is born, his parents must present him to God. Another rule was that the child's parents should give an offering to God. Mary and Joseph obeyed God and brought two birds as an offering. A man named Simeon lived in Jerusalem, and he loved God. He knew that God had promised to send someone special to save people from sin. God had told Simeon that he would not die until he saw the Messiah who would rescue people from their sins. Simeon trusted God. That day, God told Simeon to go to the temple. Simeon saw Jesus there, and he picked Jesus up in his arms. Simeon was so happy. Simeon knew that Jesus was special. Simeon praised God. He prayed, "God, I am ready to die. You kept your promise, and I have seen the one who will save people from sin." Mary and Joseph heard Simeon say those important words. Jesus was going to save people from sin. Simeon talked to Mary and Joseph. He said being Jesus' mother would be very good, but it would be very hard. Some people would love Jesus, but other people would not like him at all. Some things would happen that would make Mary very sad. another woman was in the temple, a prophetess named Anna. Anna was very old. Anna did not have a family, so she stayed at the temple all the time and worshiped God. Anna walked toward Simeon, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. When Anna saw Jesus, she thanked God. People had been waiting a long time for God to send the special one who would save people from sin. Anna told other people the good news. Jesus, the Savior, is here. Mary and Joseph did everything they were supposed to do at the temple. Then they went back home. Jesus grew up, and he was strong and healthy and wise. God was happy with Jesus. God had promised his people that a Savior was coming. When Simeon and Anna saw Jesus, they knew he was the Savior. Jesus came to save people from sin. We can trust Jesus to save us from our sins, and like Simeon and Anna, we get to tell others the good news.